Napier, being the oldest house of all, carries fabulous, flabbergasting, and unforgettable memories in the hearts of inspired men. Today we are about to show you a documentary of those who lived and living at the sacred walls of Napier. Starting with the person who started them all, Reverend H.P. Napier Clavering, from whom we take our name, was principal from 1890 to 1900. He was a great organizer, financier, builder, and disciplinarian. At his arrival of the end of June 1890, there were 260 boys and 39 boarders. This old dormitory, which was a building at that time, was pulled down in December 1896, and on its site, a large two-storied block, 85 feet long and 35 feet wide, was erected by the end of 1897. We have some photographs of some of our housemasters. We regret that we don't have all of them. Major H. J. Hardy, an old boy of Trinity, joined the staff in 1929. He was associated with the Cadet Corps and taught art. He was housemaster of both Schoolery and Napier. Major Gordon E. Burroughs. He was at the intelligence staff of Mountbatten during the World War II. After demobilization in 1946, he joined Trinity staff for 1 year. He went back to England and returned after 18 months and remained here for 14 years as co-vice principal with Mr. G. Y. Sahayan. Mr. D. Blantz. He took over the house in 1938 from Mr. King. The library was named after him. He was killed in action. Mr. Theodore De Silva, who was known as Tuffy. He joined Trinity in 1953 and housemaster in 1963. Next shown is some of our old photographs which are treasured in Napier. Even though the Golden Jubilee was in 1948, it was celebrated in 1954. This is a clip of the magazine and the house photograph. Napier had its ups and downs. Shields came and went. However, she has managed to live a life of 100 years. Next shown is the present routine of the Napierites. Drill is taken by the school officers every morning. Next shown is boys getting ready for their day-to-day life.